Wishing you a day full of joyful moments. A very good morning to all of you. Know your enemy and know yourself, and you can fight 100 battles without disaster. Disaster. Have you heard this word before also? Yes. In the previous chapter also, we had discussed about disaster or natural calamity. Today we will discuss in details. So, today we will learn about natural calamities. A calamity is an event that brings terrible losses. It is a disaster. Natural calamities are calamities caused by nature. They include disasters such as earthquakes, floods, landslides, cyclones, and volcanic eruption. Some calamities are predictable, for example, a hurricane. Some calamities, such as earthquakes, take us by surprise. We should also remember that during a calamity, we should come forward and help the victims of the calamity. It is always good for us to know about the different kinds of calamities so that we can be prepared. So, let us discuss about some natural calamities. An earthquake is a sudden, violent shaking or trembling of the earth's surface. Earthquakes are caused by the collision of the plates of rocks under the surface of the earth. Earthquakes of great intensity cause a lot of damage to life and property. In April 2015, the earthquake in Nepal took thousands of lives and caused huge damage to the property, as shown. Children, do you know, tsunami is an extremely large wave in the sea caused by an earthquake under sea. It is so strong and forceful that it wipes out towns in the coastal areas. On 9th March 2011, a tsunami of magnitude 9 struck Japan, leaving lakhs of people homeless and killing thousands of people. Due to heavy rains, rivers become so full that they spread out onto the land around them. This event in nature is called flood. During floods, large areas of dry land get submerged in water. In 2014, the flood in Jammu Kashmir caused a great damage to the lives of the people. Oh my God! What is this? This is cyclone, a fast-moving, violent and destructive windstorm. A cyclone can destroy houses and crops. A cyclone in sea brings huge volumes of water from the sea to the coastal areas. The rushing sea water destroys everything that comes in its path. Cyclones are a great threat to the people living in coastal areas. What is this? It is very dangerous. It's a volcanic eruption. A volcano is a hill with a vent. A vent reaches down to the hot molten rock beneath the surface of the earth. During a volcanic eruption, the molten rock is forced up the vent. It flows out of the top as lava. The lava flows out very fast and burns everything that comes in its way. It causes great damage to the life and property. Drought is a long period of time when there is little or no rain. It results in severe water shortage. Ponds and lakes dry up. Huge cracks develop in the soil. Due to the scarcity of water, crops are damaged. People do not have food. When a massive rock breaks off, the slides down a hillside or mountainside, it is called as landslide. It destroys everything that comes in its path. We cannot control natural forces and prevent natural calamities, but we can help the victims and try to reduce their sufferings. It is our moral duty to help one another in times of trouble. Government agencies, community and voluntary organizations do a lot towards bringing relief to the people affected by natural calamities. Money, food items, cloths, blankets and medicines are donated by the people and sent to the affected areas. Various organizations set up relief camps. They collect donation in many forms and help the affected people living in these camps. Red Cross Society provides the affected people with all types of medical help. Many doctors and nurses look after the sick, hurt, and the affected. These organizations work hard to maintain hygienic conditions in the affected area and relief camps to prevent the outbreak of an epidemic. They also organize shows and exhibitions to collect funds. Famous film stars and cricket stars participate in these shows to draw support. They also create an awareness among people about the suffering of the victims. Radio, television, and newspapers play an important role in helping the affected people. In their special reports and bulletins, they convey the messages of the affected people to their relatives living elsewhere. The telephone department provides emergency phone numbers and helpline services at relief camps during such time of crisis. The other agencies that help people affected by natural calamities are the police, the navy, and the air force. The police work to save the people, protect their property, and help them reach relief camps safely. The Navy brings its boats and the Air Force uses its helicopters to rescue people and drop food, water, medicines and other necessary items in the affected areas. As a preventive measures, we must plant more trees in our neighborhood. As a preventive measure, we must plant more trees in our neighborhood. Trees reduce the force of water during flood. Trees also act as a wind barrier during cyclones. It is therefore our duty to plant as many trees as we can. We can protect ourselves from disasters if we start taking care of our environment. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.